Hello friends, I am Professor D.T. Kashid. Let me welcome you all in the lecture series for AMUI Mains Examination, a complete guide. Today, in this lecture, we will be discussing about remaining part of sources of energy. Let us discuss the another source of energy, that is wind energy. As we know that moving air is called wind, and energy produced from the wind is called wind energy. Do you know wind is caused due to unequal heating of land and water bodies by the sun? So this unequal heating generates the air movement and causes winds to blow. So this kinetic energy of wind is used to generate wind energy from a windmills. Now, windmills is just like a large fan at some height. Also, wind causes the blades to rotate, which is in turn rotate the turbine of the electric generator, and electric energy is produced. Okay, simple principle. So, the output of single windmill is small and does not produce much electricity. Correct. So therefore, a large number of windmills is erected over a large area to produce the electricity, and these are known as wind energy farms. Correct. You can see on the slide also I have shown the wind farm example. Correct. So this is the basic principle behind the wind energy. Let us discuss the advantages of using wind energy. So wind energy is a renewable source of energy. Then wind energy does not cause any pollution. Also, it can generate energy in remote areas where other forms of energy is not possible. Along with advantages, we have the disadvantages of using wind energy. So first disadvantage is that wind energy farms can only be established where wind blows for greater part of year. Correct. Also, wind speed required to rate the turbine, okay, and so turbine should be higher than 50 kilometer per hour. Okay, then there should be some storage cells to take care of energy needs to when there is no wind. Then also establishment of wind energy farm requires a large area of land. So to, for example, to establish 1 megawatt generator farm needs 2 hectares of the land. Okay. Also, initial cost of establishment of the wind farms is very high. Okay. And also the wind turbines may kill the birds. Okay. Also, since tower and blades are exposed to nature, they should be highly maintained. Maintained in case of rain, cyclone, extreme temperatures. Okay. This is about the wind energy. Let us discuss the tidal energy. Tidal energy comes from energy generated from the tides in the sea. So normally tides are generated due to the gravitational pulls of moon. That gravitational pull of the moon, the spinning earth. Correct. So it causes high and low tides to form, and the differences in sea levels which gives us the tidal energy. Correct. Now question arises, how is tidal energy produced? Tidal energy is harnessed by constructing a dam across a narrow opening to the sea. You can see also in the diagram also here, and in that tidal energy for generation, turbine is fixed at the top of the dam, which converts the tidal energy into electricity. Okay, you can see also. Correct. So tidal energy is harnessed by constructing a dam across a narrow opening to the sea, and a turbine fixed at the top of the dam, which converts tidal energy to electricity. Okay, now here also we have some advantages of this tidal energy. It is a renewable source of energy. It does not cause any pollution to the environment, and the lifespan of the tidal energy plants are longer. Okay. Let us discuss the another source of energy, that is a wave energy. Okay. So just like we use kinetic energy of tides to make tidal energy, we use kinetic energy of waves to make wave energy. Correct. So waves are generated due to winds blowing across the surface of the sea, and different devices are used to trap that wave energy. Okay. So you can see also in the figure this schematic diagram of wave energy. Okay. So waves are generated due to winds blowing across the surface of sea, and to trap that waves we require different devices and we'll get the wave energy. Okay. Also here some advantages are there. This is, as we know, that this is a renewable source of energy. It is environmental friendly as it does not cause pollution. Also there are number of ways to harness wave energy. Also it does not cause any damage to earth. Along with advantages, we have the disadvantages of using wave energy. Like wave energy can only be used in areas where waves are very strong. Then since the waves are erratic, the energy produced from the wave energy is unpredictable. So it is not a reliable source of energy, and the initial setup costs are high. Correct. Let us discuss the another source of energy, that is ocean thermal energy. Okay. As we know that water at surface of the sea is hot. Correct. So whereas water is in the deeper section is cold. So this difference in temperature is used to transform energy in ocean thermal energy plant. Ocean thermal energy is also called OTEC. Okay. Ocean thermal energy conversion. Okay. So you can see the schematic diagram of ocean thermal energy plants. In this ocean thermal energy plant, we use water at surface and water at a depth of 2 kilometers, so that temperature difference is at least 20 degrees Celsius, and the warm surface water is used to boil the volatile liquid like ammonia, and the vapors of the ammonia are used to turn the turbines of the generator. You can see in the schematic, and the cold water of the at the bottom is used to pump up to condense the vapor into liquid. Okay, you can see. So this is the principle of ocean thermal energy. Now here also we have the some advantages. Okay, power generated from OTEC is renewable and it is free from pollution. Also the output generated from the ocean thermal energy shows very little seasonal or daily variation. Also electric power generated can also be used to produce hydrogen. Okay, and the cold water pumped in this plant can be used for other things such as air conditioning and the repression. Now here also we have the disadvantages. So it is only suitable in a tropical regions since water at the surface can only be heated there, and the initial setup costs are high. Now let us discuss the geothermal energy. Now this geothermal energy is a heat energy from hot rocks present inside the earth. So as we know that very hot water coming from inside the surface of the earth. But how does it happen? Now in the earth's core there are molten rocks which have high temperature, and due to geological changes these molten rocks are pushed upwards and trapped in a region called hot spots, okay, where underground water comes in contact with this hot spot, then steam is generated from that water, and this steam is trapped in the rocks. When steam finds a way to go to the surface of the earth, then hot springs are formed. So this is a basic point, okay, how these hot springs are generated or formed. Now, using geothermal energy, we can generate the energy, okay. So what are the steam trapped in the rock? So that can be used to rotate the turbine and generate the electricity. So it is called geothermal power plant. You can see the schematic diagram of geothermal power plant also, okay, how we are taking the hot water and how it is converted into the steam and to for rotating the turbine, and how the electricity is generated is through this generator, okay. Also here we have the advantages of using geothermal energy. As we know that they are environmental friendly, also it is renewable source of energy, okay, they produce large amount of energy, okay, it can produce energy 24 hours a day, okay, 7 days a week, 365 days a year, okay. Also geothermal energy plants have low operating cost. Now along with advantages, we have the disadvantages of using geothermal. First is that there are very few commercial viable sites to exploit geothermal energy. Also the cost of set up geothermal energy plant is high, and the construction of geothermal plants are affect the that stability of land, and may in extreme cases cause earthquake also, okay. So these points we have to keep in our mind. Now let us discuss the last source of energy, that is nuclear energy. Now the energy released during the nuclear reaction, it is called nuclear energy, correct, and the nuclear reactions are of two types. First is the nuclear fission and second is the nuclear fusion. Now let us study both of them. Nuclear fission means what? In nuclear fission, nucleus of the heavy atom like uranium, plutonium, thorium is bombarded with a low energy neutrons, and it split into lighter nuclei. This difference in mass between the original nucleus and the nuclei after fission gives rise to the tremendous energy, and this energy is given by the equation, as we know that E is equal to mc square, where m is a difference of mass and c is the speed of light. The fission of atom of the uranium produces 10 million times the energy produced by burning coal, okay. So please note that nuclear energy, and we use nuclear fission to generate electricity in a nuclear power plant, okay. Now let us talk about the nuclear fission fusion. In nuclear fusion, we join lighter nucleus to make a heavier nucleus, and it produces tremendous amount of energy, and this same energy is source of is the source of energy in sun and stars, correct. And the conditions required for fusion are extreme, millions of degree of temperature and millions of pascals of pressure, okay. Now do you know what happens in a nuclear bomb? In nuclear bomb, fission of uranium or plutonium takes place at a core, and this core is embedded in a substance containing deuterium and lithium, and when bomb is detonated, fission takes place and the temperature of substance is raised to 107 okay in a few microseconds, and this provides the condition of fission of lighter nuclei to take place. And due to nuclear fission, a devastating amount of or more amount of energy is released. Okay, now I will show the nuclear power plant. Okay, now the nuclear power plant is based on the idea of nuclear fission. So in nuclear power plant, nuclear fuel undergoes self-sustaining fission reaction, and which releases the energy at a controlled rate. Okay, now also here we have the advantages of nuclear energy. First is that it produces a large amount of energy for a small amount of fuel. And once we put the nuclear fuel in a reactor, it can produce energy for 2 or 3 years continuously. We do not need to put fuel again and again. Also, no greenhouse gas is emitted while producing nuclear energy. Now, along with these advantages, we have the disadvantages. First is that major hazard of nuclear power generation is disposal of used fuel, used uranium. Okay. It still decay into a subatomic particle, that is radiation. Okay, also improper nuclear waste storage and disposal may result in environmental contamination. Okay, so there is a risk of leakage of nuclear radiation also. Okay, so this is about the nuclear power plant. So this is about today's lecture, that is storage sources of energy. In the next lecture, we'll discuss about laws of thermodynamics. So please stay tuned for more videos regarding this RTO AMUI mains examination, and please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to receive notification regarding more videos from this lecture series. Let's crack. Okay, thank you very much.